born 2001, May 16th, in Brewton, Alabama, a broken small town. And I was in there for at least 2 months after I was born because I was a preemie and I was supposed to be born in August with my twin brother. After that, my biological mom couldn't keep us, so she gave us to this lady, Laura Grace. From then on, we called her mom. We grew up differently. We grew up poor on food stamps, but we were loved by my older brother and my cousins. My biological mom had 8 kids, 3 sets of twins, and the rest were a little girl and a son. She raised us to be polite, yes ma'am, no ma'am, and we learned from her that everything is possible if you try. She worked every day, so our older brothers took care of us. Even though she was barely there to help raise us, she did everything she could to keep us with her. And these are my older brothers now. We get to see them a couple times a year, actually. Last year we got to see them for a whole month. They live in Florida. The one holding my nephew just got back from deployment in Africa. He's in the Air Force. My other brother works on an oil rig in Texas. My other one lives in Greensboro, North Carolina. We get to see them when we need to, and they always call and text. So, in 2011, my mom died. She was an amazing woman, and she was always there for any of her children. That's why we have different families who foster and take care of different families. This one, the 2 kids, their parents weren't able to take care of them, so they were adopted by our respite parents. And we grew up with them too in the foster care system. They're some pretty awesome people. Then there's these amazing people. They are our foster parents for a second year in foster care. They adopted 2 deaf girls that lived with us. And then they had 2 kids of their own, Link and Lucy. We grew up with every single child pretty much on these pictures. And learning sign language was hard, but we got it down. And then there's the Joneses. They're my family, and I love them. So they adopted 5 kids. That's hard work, because adopting kids isn't exactly always easy. And then there's us after we were adopted in 2013. There's the symbol of adoption. It shows that there's the family that gave you up, the adoptee, and the adoptive parents. Everyone has love on why they gave you up, or there's a reason why someone wants to adopt you. And then the adoptee has to show the love to the family who gives you up and who adopts you. That's why many American children in the welfare system is badly broken, and it needs to be fixed, yes. Because my brother has 1 felony against him. He tried to adopt us, but the justice system wouldn't allow. And they can suffer harm as a result. And some being separated from their siblings. They couldn't do that for me and my brother because we're twins, and that would be heartbreaking because we grew up together. We bounced to foster care system, placement, another, never knowing when our lives will be uprooted next. I bounced to house, but at least I knew the families that took care of me because they went to my school. 2015, more than 20,000 young people aged out of the foster care system without permanent families. The age out age is 18 years old. Research show that these families who leave care without being linked to forever families have a higher likelihood than youth with general population experience homelessness, unemployment, and incarceration as adults. The reason why I'm trying to get more people to adopt or foster is so kids have a chance in life rather than just living on the streets. On any given day, there are nearly 428,000 children spent in the foster care system. I was one of those kids. Also, in 2015, more than half entering the foster care were young people of color. Where I was, me and my brother were the only colored kids, so we were pretty lucky. But I didn't see many colored kids go through foster care. So that means either they're with their family or they are somewhere, hopefully that's really nice. 2015, more than 62,000 children whose mothers and fathers' permanent rights have been legally terminated for waiting to be adopted. The court gives you a certain time, gives the parent a certain time to sign a paper saying they still want parental rights for the child. For us, that took forever. We had to go to court at least once a month, skip school, and wait and see if our biological parents would show up to court and sign the papers. Finally, 2012, the court decided that if they weren't going to show up this last time, that their rights were terminated. They never showed up, so their rights were terminated for the last time. And being adopted, you're racially diverse, like my family now. My father's Mexican mixed, my two sisters are Indian mixed, my brother and I are African American, and my mom is just plain out white. And that's a good thing, even if you get crazy looks out in public. But it shows people that there's hope in different families. Where we come from is a small town called Chimucla. Don't try to say it because it's probably impossible. There was problems being the only two African American in that pretty much the whole town, but we enjoyed it. We had lots of friends. And once we entered the foster care system, they've never seen an issue like mine and my brother's. So they put us in the newspaper. We had a photo shoot. Wore pretty much matching clothes. That was the last time we ever did that. And twins, yes. Sometimes I wish we were, because everyone thinks he's older. But we had fun doing different things, and me and him loved baseball. And that's why I'm encouraging families to adopt and so everyone has hope in the world.